morning everyone, welcome back to today's online session of grade 4. Okay children, hope you all are using your time wisely in doing studies. Okay children, I wanted to thank those children who are sending me such a beautiful homework. You are following all the instructions that I am giving you, so thank you so much students for that. And what is our today's topic, children? Our today's topic is interjection. Okay, children, this is the last part, eighth part of the parts of speech. Okay, children. So you have studied in the previous class in the grade 3, that is interjection. So what do you mean by interjection, children? What do you mean by interjection? Interjections are the words that shows sudden feelings. Okay? Interjections are the words that shows sudden feelings like sorrow, joy, and surprise. Okay, children, interjections are the words that shows sudden feeling. Okay, children, we express some strong feelings through our expression, whether it may be joy, sorrow, or surprise. Okay, children, interjections are the words that show some strong feelings like joy, sorrow, or surprise. Okay, it can be a part of sentence sometimes. Okay, it can be a part of sentence sometimes and also stands alone with exclamation mark. Okay, children, always interjections stands with exclamation marks. Okay, children, interjections stands with exclamation mark. So this is the exclamation mark. Okay, we are using interjection to show some strong feelings like joy, sorrow, or surprise. Okay, children, an interjection which is added to a sentence to express some sudden feeling, joy, sorrow, surprise. Okay, it can be a part of sentence sometimes and it also stands alone with the exclamation mark. So this is the exclamation mark, children. So what do you mean by interjections? Interjections are the words which shows some sudden feelings, okay, like sorrow, surprise, or joy. Okay, children, we are using exclamation mark. Okay, we are using exclamation mark with the examples of the interjections. We always use interjection marks, exclamation mark with the interjection. So children, so this is the interjection. This is the exclamation mark which we are using with the interjections. Okay, children. So here we have some examples for interjections. Hello. Hi. Alas. Wow. Ouch. Hooray. Ah. Oh. So these are the some interjections. Okay, children, these are the some examples for interjection. Okay, children, pay attention on voice modulation. Okay, children, voice modulation is very important in English language, especially in interjection, to show our some sudden strong feelings. Okay, here, hello, hi, alas, wow, ouch, hooray, These are the some examples for interjection. Here, while pronouncing, the interjection voice modulation is very important in English language. Okay, children, wherever you are talking, wherever you are speaking, the interjection in you are using the interjections in sentences, you have to use the voice modulation for these interjections. Okay, hello, hi, loss, wow, ouch, hooray, ah, oh. So these are the voice modulation for the interjection. These are the few examples for interjections. Okay, children, now here are some common interjection and the feeling they express. Okay, children, here I have written on the board some common interjection which we are using in daily basis of sentences. So here we have some common interjections with the feelings, okay, with the feelings they express. Okay, so here the first one we have, alas. Okay, how we are going to pronounce this? The voice modulation is very important in the interjection, children. So how do we pronounce it? Alas, alas. So alas shows the feeling of grief. Okay, children, so what do you mean by grief? This is the intense sorrow. This shows, alas shows intense sorrow. Sorrow means dukkha. Okay, grief means intense sorrow, dukkha. Okay, so here alas we are using to show grief means dukkha. Okay, so here alas, alas shows grief. Alas we are using, alas is the interjection which is used to show grief. Grief means dukkha, intense sorrow, to indicate the intense sorrow. Okay, so here alas is used to show grief. Okay, children, the second one, look at the second one, hooray. Okay, children, the second one is hooray. So here, what is the pronunciation of hooray? What is the voice modulation here? Hooray! Okay, so hooray is the interjection used to show joy. Okay, children, joy means happiness. Okay, so hooray is an interjection hooray is the interjection used to show the joy. Okay, children, so here hooray is used to show joy. Okay, the next one we have, oh. Okay, children, what is the pronunciation of this? O-N-H, oh. So here, oh is an interjection used to show sadness or wonder. Okay, oh is an interjection used to show sadness or wonder. Okay, children, so what is the voice modulation here? Alas, hooray, oh. Okay, children, look at the next one. The next word is here, hello. Okay, hello. So hello is an interjection used to express, okay, used to greet someone. Okay, children, when we meet someone, we use hello interjection. Okay, children, whenever we are meeting someone, first we used to greet them. So here, greet, for greeting we are using hello interjection. Okay, so here hello is an interjection used to show greet. Okay, greet somebody. Hello is a word used to greet somebody. Whenever we meet someone, we used to say hello, isn't it? So hello is a word used to greet somebody, wish somebody. Okay children, now look at the next one. Ah, so here ah is also shows grief, means sorrow, intense sorrow, dukkha. Okay, ah, ah is used to show grief. Then look at the next one children. Ush, so here ush an indication to somebody to quiet. Okay children, ush is an interjection used to show, used to indicate to someone to quiet. Okay, we are using ush to someone to quiet. Okay, ush is an interjection used to indicate to be someone quiet. Okay, it is ush. Here H is silent. Okay, so ush is an interjection. Okay, look at the next one. Bravo. Bravo is used to show appreciation. Okay, so here bravo is we are using to appreciate someone who has done great job. Okay children, so here appreciation is used to show bravo interjection. Okay, now look at the next one. What, so here what we are using to show surprise or an anger, angriness. Okay, sit to. So here what is an interjection used to show surprise or anger. Okay children, so what are the interjections? Interjections are the words used to show some sudden feelings like sorrow, surprise. It can be a part of the sentence sometimes and also stands alone with the exclamation mark. Okay, take down the screenshot of this children so that later on you can write it. Take the screenshot of this. Take the screenshot of this children. Okay, now let us see some examples how we gonna use these interjections in sentences. Okay children, so here we have, wow, look at that beautiful painting. So here we have the first example. Wow, look at that beautiful painting. Wow is an interjection used to show surprise. Children, wow, look at that beautiful painting. Okay Okay, children. The word interjection stand with the exclamation mark. Wow! Look at that beautiful painting here. Wow! Is expressing the feeling of surprise. Okay, children. So here wow is an interjection which shows the surprise. Okay. Look at the next one. Push. The baby is sleeping. Push. The baby is sleeping. Okay. The baby is sleeping. So here, push is an interjection, stands with exclamation mark. Okay. Two. Push is an interjection used to indicate to someone to be quiet. Okay, children. So here, push. The baby is sleeping. So push is here an interjection. So here O stands with your exclamation mark. Okay, children. The interjections can be the part of sentence sometimes, and they also stands with exclamation mark sometimes. Okay, children. So here these examples, the interjections stands with exclamation mark. Okay, children. O is used to show the sadness or wonder. Look at the next one. It was sad to hear that you are very sad. It was sad to hear. It was sad to hear that you are very sad. So here stands with exclamation mark to show the grief. Okay, children, to show the grief. So here it was sad to hear you are very sad. So here is expressing the feeling of grief. Children, here wow is expressing the feeling of surprise. Here ush is indicate to be quiet, and here is an interjection used to show the sadness, and is also used to show the grief. So here wow, ush, are the interjections. Okay, children. Now, let us solve some exercise part for the interjections. Part of speech, children. This is the last part of speech, that is interjection. In the next class, we will be starting our syllabus, children. Fill in the blanks. Fill in the blanks with appropriate interjection. fill in the blanks with appropriate interjection that given in the bracket. That given in the bracket. So here we have the first question, children. Dash. Hello. Nice to meet you after years. Nice to meet you after years. Let me write all the questions first, children. Later we will solve the questions. So, second one we have dash. Hooray. Ush. We have won the trophy. We have won the trophy. Okay, children, we have won the trophy. Third one, dash, bravo, alas. Sachin Tendulkar has played a brilliant innings. Sachin Tendulkar. As Sachin Tendulkar has played a brilliant innings. Fourth one, dash, what? I am sorry. I am sorry to hear. I am sorry to hear of your grandparents' demise. Of your grandparents' demise. Okay, children. So look at the first one, children. Fill in the blanks with appropriate interjection that given in the bracket. So here in the bracket we have two interjections. So we have to choose the correct appropriate interjection which is suitable for the sentences which are given here. The children, look at the first one. Dash, nice to meet you after years. So here, whenever we meet someone, what we are using, children? What we are using to say? Whenever we greet somebody, which interjection we use, children? Or hello? Yes, we just came across from that. We use hello to greet somebody. So here, nice to meet you after years is here greeting somebody with the interjection. Hello. So here we have to use hello interjection because here nice to meet you after years. So here meeting is going on there. So whenever we meet someone, we have to greet them with the hello word, with the hello interjection. So hello is here an interjection to greet somebody. Okay children, so your sentence is nice to meet you after years. So hello we have to use as interjection to greet somebody. Okay children, now look at the second one. Dash, we have won the trophy. So here, hooray, we are using to show the joy. Okay children, hooray, we are using to show the joy. Look at the second one children, we have won the trophy. So this sentence is expressing the joy. So for joy, which interjection we have to use? Ush or hooray children? Yes, hooray is an interjection used to show the joy. So here hooray we have to use, because here we have won the trophy is expressing the joyness. Okay, so here we have to use hooray with the exclamation mark. Children, now look at the third one. Dash, Sachin Tendulkar has a brilliant innings. So here we have to use alas or bravo children. Here there are two options, bravo or alas. So here bravo we are using to appreciate somebody, and alas we are using to show the grief. Grief means sorrow, dukkha. So here Sachin Tendulkar has played brilliant innings. Is it a joy? Is it appreciation or grief children? Yes, it is appreciation. So here we have to use bravo or alas? We have to use bravo, because bravo is used to show the appreciation, used to express the appreciation. So here bravo we have to use as interjection with the exclamation mark. Children, now look at the fourth one. Dash, I'm sorry to hear your grandparents demand. So here what and are the two interjections given here. So here what we are using, what interjection we are using to show the wonder or surprise, and we are using to show the grief. Grief means intense sorrow, means dukkha. So here grandparents' demise, is it showing grief or surprise children? Grandparents' demise is showing the intense sorrow, means we have to use interjection. Interjection is used to show grief, means intense sorrow, dukkha. So grandparents' demise is showing the intense sorrow. So here we have to use a interjection. Okay children, so let us read once again. Hello, nice to meet you after years. Hello, nice to meet you after years. So here and hello are the two interjection. We have to choose the correct one. So we have used hello to greet somebody. Okay children, now look at the second one. Hooray, we have won the trophy. So here we have used hooray. Why children? Because it shows the joy. It indicates the joy. Okay children, hooray, we have won the trophy. So here interjection stands with the exclamation mark. Okay children, now look at the third one. Bravo, Sachin Tendulkar has played a brilliant innings. So bravo we are using to show the appreciation. So here Sachin, we are appreciating here Sachin Tendulkar for the great brilliant innings. So here bravo is an interjection. Look at the fourth one. I am sorry to hear your grandparents' demise. So grandparents' demise is showing here grief means dukkha. So for grief we are using ah. Okay. So these are the interjection. Like this, we have to use the correct interjection, which is suitable for the sentences. Okay, children. Now take the screenshot of this. Take the screenshot, children, so that later on you can write it. So what are the interjections, children? Interjections are the words which show some sudden strong feelings like joy, sorrow or surprise. Okay, children, hello, hi, alas, hooray, bravo, ouch, oh, ah, are the some examples for interjections. Okay, children, now it is time to give you some homework part. So your today's homework is write same as last word. Okay, children, I will be sending this interjection notes in the study material option in your Teachment app, children. I will be sending this interjection notes, so you can copy from that, children. Okay, you don't need to write by watching the recordings. You can see the notes for the writing purpose. Okay, children, I have sent till then whatever the parts of speech I have taught you, I have sent all the notes in the study material option in your Teachment app. Okay, children, it is beside the recording option. So you can go through the notes which I have sent in the Teachment app. Okay, children, no need to write by watching the recordings. You can see the notes and write it. Okay, children, so here your homework is write same as classwork. I will be sending this interjection notes in the Teachment app so that you can copy easily. Okay, children, so this is your today's homework. Hope you all have understood today's class. Okay, children, in next class we will be starting our fourth standard syllabus. Okay, children, now it is time to end our today's class. Let us meet in the next session with the new topic. Till then, have a good day. Bye bye, children.